Yes, you got it, yeah. I'm going to see.
This is just going to be replaced with no, and same circuit to the other.
Right, we got to work with the circuits in there, right. Did you guys all hear that? All right, because I don't like writing. I don't got to write.
This light here, we're going to have new EM, this will be a change up, we're going to put the one in the same box.
And all the EMs will go through, there is a circuit over here that says EM on it. Because as you can notice, we don't have a fire alarm system in this building, that's something down the road. So we'll be.
Yeah.
This used to be a locker room for men and all that, and now this one be converted into a safety panel for children. So you see, we got some funny spots here dipping, we got to seal these up for Illinois plumbing code, level it out. And here we have BCT top. So you have to tear the floor, and again, that's what that alternate did. Part of the alternate for this floor. The ceiling block walls stay the way they are. Anything that's hanging out, like all this is coming off. Anytime you got a divot in the dink, we just want to fill it in, try to make it look clean. All the lights, fixtures, and all that are coming out. The grid, or this is staying, we're going to put a new grid in. We're going to come down to a minimum. Now, everybody makes different depths of light fixtures, so I'm coming off with that now. So if this drywall stays here, we're going to come down roughly 5 inches, 6 inches. But I'm going to try to stay as tight as possible. We also have a light fixture up in here that we call that. In this corner here, and I'll start from high and come down low. This is the existing ductwork. It was done from a project a while ago. You can feel it's putting out the heat. We're just putting new, magically things line up just right. So it's a good thing.
What? As long as you're talking about. So this. You want the ductwork capped? I saw something about plywood.
Yeah, we're going to put a chunk of plywood in there, shove it up in there, and then put a piece of drywall across it. Right. And that's classified as not fire type, but it'll be all right.
Gotcha.
Go to the problem. Oh, by the way, the drawings have been taken in. The reason why I'm hobbling is I'm going to get hit replacement. So the drawings have been approved. This ain't about me. I'm just letting you know the drawings are approved. Whoever gets the job is going to walk up, bring your trades in, come license and bind them with the village. All right? So there's no games that they will say, right? It's all taken care of, right? All you got to do is have a sharp pencil in. And this company went. So, yeah. What we're doing over here is, as you'll see on the drawings and the reflective ceiling, we don't want to move pipes. Save money. We're putting a little soffit drywall system here to mimic it. We're doing the same thing over here. Also, on the drawings, we're calling out this here to be patched and repaired. Basically, cut it out, push it back up. That was the direction of the code official. We don't have a fireman painting, just make it so fire don't get through. We have this existing piping assembly here, which were shower heads. Again, with the 6 inches and all that, it does service areas outside a fountain assembly. So it is utilized. So basically, we're taking this out and just putting the chunk of copper in. We'll come up just to the shut off valve, call it a day, and just reconnect. Any questions so far, gentlemen?
About this clip?
This is going to be, when you see on drawings, it talks about scruffing this up. There's a product on Seiko, there's a couple different ones, we're grabbing this fill in concrete. Over here, we're blasting with this gentleman's stand, we're blasting that out. In my heart, in my mind, it should be just cables getting underneath and chisel it out. Should be, it wasn't part of, you know, initial concrete pour, I think. Normally, but we'll find out. They will let me touch it.
Blockers.
And you see what we're coming, we go off that door right there. We're going to have a screen here that'll be installed by the HPD people, their own in-house crews. So while we got the ceiling open, we got the new grid, the ceiling drawings, it's a universal, I call them octopus spider assembly. We don't know what it's going to be yet, Matt, but that's here. And then on the wall, we're calling out on that same alternate. That's a big one there where we're using, we're not going to go into the wall, but we got four new outlets. So we're just going to have the exposed metallic product that we called out. There's three different other companies that make this stuff. Because we're going to have kids in here, we don't want plastic. They're going to get into it just like beavers and rip it right off. So we'll go with the metal. But in this alternate here, we're coming down with three so that we can feed. As you all know, low loads can't mix with high voltage. So because by the time this all happens, we have no idea what the technology is going to be, but at least we'll look in the cabinets. And again, there are people who install that stuff. And so we're looking at as an alternate, just setting up, make sure it's anchored properly, sealing good goes over that thing, and then we're coming down, aim over on that alternate.
So you want for the low voltage, it's a 700 wire mold drop that's sufficient?
Yeah, that's what we're going.
Okay.
Any other questions?
I think that's...